The nervous system is a network of cells that orchestrates human actions, both voluntary and involuntary, through sending signals back and forth from all parts of the body. The cells that make up the nervous system are divided into two types, neurons and glial cells. As the messengers of the body that receive and send messages within the system, neurons have a special structure. Its dendrites are tasked to receive messages from other cells and transmit them to the cell body, which in turn sends the messages to axon. To transmit those messages to the other cells, the axon of one cell and the receivers of the others form a structure called synapse. Based on functions, the nervous system is broken down into two systems. The central nervous system is composed of the brain and the spinal cord. The brain is the center of the nervous system. Similar to a computer's CPU, the brain takes information from all of the senses, stores it, processes it, makes decisions based on it, and sends commands out to the body. Anatomically, the brain is made up of forebrain, midbrain, and hindbrain. The forwardmost portion, the forebrain, is responsible for cognitive activities such as perceiving, thinking, producing and understanding language, plus different critical activities related to emotion and motion function. The midbrain is the part involved in auditory and visual, as well as motor function. The hindbrain helps maintain balance and coordinate movement. In short, brain is the big boss of the body. However, it would be a useless boss without a spinal cord. Spinal cord carries messages between the body and the brain. It's also responsible for very fast and life-saving reflexes, like pulling back the finger when touching a hot kettle, for example. The peripheral nervous system is made up of all the nerves and neurons outside the brain and the spinal cord, and is responsible for carrying information to and from the central nervous system. The somatic nervous system allows the brain and the spinal cord to communicate with the sensory system and allows the brain and the spinal cord to control the muscles and glands of the body. The autonomic nervous system is divided into sympathetic and parasympathetic nervous systems. The sympathetic nervous system activates our organs to make the body ready in response to threat. The parasympathetic nervous system calms the body down to normal functioning after arousal and serves basic life functions such as heart beating. To study brain and the way it functions, many approaches have been adopted. One way is to study animals or people with brain damage to see what's happened to their abilities. Another way is to record electrical abilities of the neurons with an electroencephalograph, or EEG. Nowadays, several new approaches are developed to look further inside the human brains, such as CT scan, MRI, PET, fMRI, etc. Now let's recap what we have just introduced to you via the following mind map. Thank you for watching Easy Psych, and see you in our next video.